I just got a cool little minion that's gung-ho to try some experiments. So what do you think would happen if we let him play with high-voltage electricity? In this project, we're repurposing a neon sign transformer to power some mad science experiments and push the boundaries on cooking with electricity. Let's start this experiment with a neon sign transformer. This one's 12,000 volts and current limited to 30 milliamps, which basically means it's less likely to kill you. These kind of NSTs are getting outdated and thrown away all the time, so if you make friends with a contractor in the electric sign industry, you might be able to get a whole load of them just for buying them lunch. Ask me how I know that. Let's connect a couple of alligator clips to either side of the high voltage terminals, then carefully connect the hot and neutral leads to 120 volts AC. With the NST powered up, you can actually feel the wires buzzing, and if they get too close to each other, the electricity jumps from one lead to the other, forming an electric bridge. This kind of electricity is very aggressive, so make sure you don't get your hands too close to the leads themselves, because you don't want the electricity jumping into you. Now for our first experiment, I stopped by a local toy store and got a little helper. His name is Stuart, and we'll start by strapping 10-inch nail spikes to his hands, secured in place with black zip ties. If we clip the leads from the NST directly to the spikes and turn on the power, our little minion gets a fascinating look at electrified plasma up close and personal. Now you might have noticed the tips of the nails glowing purple, and the electricity seems to be really, really stretchy. That's because once it jumps the gap, the electrons ionize the air, making it more conductive, essentially forming a conduit that lets power flow without wires. This is one of the reasons the high voltage is so dangerous, because it can literally jump right through the air and bite you if you get too close. Alright, let's try something a little safer. I just built a Jacob's ladder out of a 3/16 inch steel rod and a wooden base that I spray painted silver. The rods aren't connected, but you can see there's a place for hooking a high voltage lead to each individual rod. I bent the wires so they're a quarter inch apart at the bottom, then gradually spread upward to 3.5 inches at the top. These magnetic balls at the tips are just to make it look cooler. If we clip a lead to each of the rods, we can safely plug in our NST and turn on the power from a distance. Now check out what's going on between the rods. There's enough voltage for the electricity to jump the air gap at the bottom, then the arcs immediately rocket upward, climbing toward the top. This happens because when the electrons jump the gap, they heat the air between the rods, and as you know, hot air rises. The rising air carries the electricity upward until it gets stretched so wide it can't hang on anymore, so it gives up and goes back to jumping the easier gap at the bottom, which you can see repeats over and over again indefinitely. Alright, let's try something a little bit different. If we try holding the electrodes horizontally, you can see the arc doesn't have anywhere to go. It just sits there peacefully. But watch what happens if we blow on it with a straw. The plasma quickly dissipates, and you can see individual streams of electrons jump in the gap, and a beautiful purple corona spreading off to the sides, which kind of looks like an electrical cotton candy. Now for one last experiment, what do you think would happen if we tried skewering two marshmallows with the two electrodes? Look closely at the gap when we turn on the power, and you'll see purple sparks jumping around, heating the marshmallows from the inside out, which apparently makes it bubble and morph like something right out of a sci-fi movie. A few seconds later, you can see mini smoke rings shooting all around the room, and just when we thought things couldn't get any crazier, the whole thing bursts into flames. Well, I guess that's just what you'd expect when you hire a minion to do mad science experiments. Well, now you know how to repurpose old NSTs to build a 12,000 volt Jacob's ladder, or just to try roasting marshmallows with science. Well, that's it for now. If you like this project, perhaps you like some of my others. Check them out at thekingofrandom.com. Hey guys, thanks for watching to the end. If you want to see another video, just click here to go back one or click here to go forward. I've also made some playlists for you. Random weekend projects, random experiments, life hacks, and mad science. If you can't click the screen, just look for these links in the description. I post new videos every 5 days, so please subscribe, and I'll see you around for the next one. Talk to you then.